Hello and welcome to lesson three. Let's begin. In this chapter, we will review chapter two, match verbs, do Q&A, do office communication, talk about body language, adverbs of frequency, and review the lesson. Let's begin. In last lesson, we learned for regular verbs, we add ed to the end to make it past tense. Faxed, messaged, phoned. Okay? Irregular verbs have their own rules, and we just have to memorize their forms, like buy, bought, pay, paid. For verbs, affirmative verbs, we change, and negative verbs, we don't change the form of the verb. She ran. She didn't run. Okay, run stays the same for negative and changes for affirmatives. Okay, auxiliary verbs are also known as helping verbs. They include do, have, and be. And question words can tell us what kind of answer is expected. Where is a location? When is a time? What time is also a time? Who is a person? Why is a reason? And often includes because. How much is a number? Generally money. What is an explanation? And how are directions? To begin, let's match the words on the left to those on the right. What category on the right does each phrase belong to on the left? Okay, so for example, do you make to work, log on to work, go to work, have to work, take to work, read to work, or get to work? Which one makes sense? As you can see, there can be more than one answer. So you might go to work or I have to get to work. Okay, both of those will work. Pause the video and practice. Make a list on each side and match them together. Here are the answers. You might make a noise or make a phone call. You might log on to the computer. You might go to work, go to the bathroom, go outside, or go to the server. You might have a cigarette, have a coffee, have an hour for lunch. You might take a message. You might read an email or a magazine. You might get someone angry. You might get someone. You might get angry. You might get a magazine. You might get to the server. There's a lot of different things you might do. All right, let's have a look at this conversation. No, I'm in a bad mood again. Sally makes me so angry. So what question would make sense here? If someone starts a conversation this way, what question should you ask? Look at the response. Because. So think of a question word that would require because as an answer. Because we all start work at 9 o'clock, but she gets here at 9:15, and the office manager never says anything to her. Okay, again, what question could you ask here? Look at the answer. Yes, of course he knows. So it's a yes answer. We have to think, what word what word makes sense? Question word would come up with the answer. Yes, of course he knows. He always says good morning to her when she arrives. And it's not just that. Then she goes to the bathroom. Now, what question would follow up about the bathroom? What question makes sense here? 15 minutes. And she nearly always comes back with a cup of coffee in her hand. She hardly ever offers to get one for us. What question could come here? After that? So that's the answer. After that, what question can we ask where the answer is another question after that? What does She logs onto her computer and spends half an hour reading the BBC News website. Then she goes into the manager's office for a chat once a day. Another half an hour wasted. Really, she doesn't do anything. I am often the only one who works in this office. All right, so we know this person is upset, okay? And the other person responding is asking questions. And the upset person is giving a lot of answers. So we can determine the questions by the answers. That's how we figure it out. Look at the answers and decide the question. So let's pause the video now and see if you can answer. What are the questions? What questions go in each blank? Here are some hints for you. How long does she spend in the bathroom? What does she do after that? Why does she make you angry? Does the manager know she arrives late? So now that you have these hints, can you match them to the right slots? Give it a try. All right, so I've added and read some potential questions you might ask. No, I'm in a bad mood again. Sally makes me so angry. Why? Because. So we know that because is always an answer for why. Okay, so that makes sense for why to be the question. Does your office manager know? Yes, of course he knows. So we see that yes is the question word. If yes is the question word, we know that do you like coffee? Yes or no? Okay. Another form of do is does. Does your office manager know? Yes, of course he knows. We see the same verb, know, to know. So it makes sense to have, does your office manager know in this slot? How long is she in the bathroom? 15 minutes. So we see that 15 minutes is the answer. So the question has to be a time question. How long is a time question? Okay. And we saw earlier that she was in the bathroom. So the bathroom needs to be in this question. And last, what does she do after that? After that question, right? After that, she logs onto her computer. So we know the question needs to be something to do with after that. Okay. All right. So now let's talk about the function of each complaint. So if you have a coworker who's telling you these things, you might wonder, what am I supposed to say? Or why are they saying this to me? I haven't done anything wrong. Okay. So for each section, let's talk about why this coworker is saying what they're saying and what they're looking for. So the first part, no, I'm in a bad mood again. So we see again, which means this happens frequently. Okay. So this is a frustration that has not been addressed. This person has been angry for a while. Okay. And it's not been solved. Next, the next section talks about how she comes in at 9 o'clock, or no. The next section talks about how she comes in at 9:15 when everyone else comes in at 9 o'clock, and the office manager doesn't care. And so this person is feeling like there's some favoritism. The office manager likes her more than they like this person, and there's a double standard. Everyone else has to come to the office at 9, but this lady can come whenever she wants. So this person is feeling frustrated by this favoritism. Okay. The last part, he always says good morning to her when she arrives, and that's not it. She also goes to the bathroom. So this person is feeling powerless. They can't do anything about it because Sally can do what she wants with no consequences, and the boss knows about it. So there's nothing they can do, and it just doesn't seem fair. Moving on to the next part, she hardly ever offers to get one for us. So Sally never gets a coffee for anybody else. Okay, so this person's feeling contempt, like angry. It's not fair and it's not kind. The least she can do is get me some coffee, right? And then the last section talking about she doesn't do anything. I'm the only one who works in this office. This person is feeling underappreciated. They feel their work is not being appreciated properly. They feel like it's not fair, and they are not talking about you specifically. So if they're having this conversation with you and they say, "I'm the only one who works in this office," they don't really mean that. That is an exaggeration. They're just really frustrated and angry, and they need to get it all out. Okay. So don't take that personally. This person's just angry. They're not feeling appreciated, and it's not your fault, and they're not blaming you. All right, so what's your role in this situation? If you have someone coming to you who's super angry and they're saying all this stuff, what are they looking for and what can you do about it? So first, if you have time and energy, you're not too busy, you can ask questions and then show sympathy. So ask questions about what's going on. Why is she doing that? Does the manager know? That sort of thing. And then you can say, "I'm so sorry that's happening. That's really not fair. You know, that's really frustrating. I can see why you're frustrated. That doesn't seem fair at all." Right? So show some sympathy. If you have no time or energy, you don't have time to talk about it, or you're very tired, you can show sympathy. "I'm so sorry that that's happening," but use your body language to show that you're busy. So reach for the phone. Close off your body, turn towards your desk, use your body to show you don't have time to talk. Last, advice may not be appropriate in this situation. If someone is this angry, they probably don't want advice. They probably just want to express themselves unless they ask you, "What do you think? What should I do? What would you do?" Then you can offer advice. But generally, in these situations, advice isn't really the role. Your role is to listen and to show sympathy. Okay, so let's talk about body language. Body language can be different across the world. So, in the workplace, you might see different kinds of body language that you're used to than you're used to. So, looking at these pictures, how does each of these people feel? Do they look like they have time to talk? Do they look happy? Do they look stressed? Do they look busy? Is now a good time to approach them? I would say no. Looking at all three of these pictures, each person looks stressed, like they have a lot going on and they have a lot to do and not enough time. So, unless you must approach, it might be best to wait until a later time. Looking at these pictures, we see something different. So we're still in the office, but each of these people has a pleasant smile on their face. Their body language is open. They're not touching their temples. They're not hunching over their desk. They're not on the phone. Each of these people has a relaxed expression on their face, and they look like they are ready to have a conversation. So if you need something right now, is a good time to ask each of these people. Let's do some practice. So, looking at this gentleman sitting at the desk, I see he's on the telephone and he's also typing on his computer. Now, if I have something I need to say to him, is now a good time? Probably not. He looks a little bit busy. When he finishes his phone call, it might be a better time. Looking at this group of individuals, is it a good time to talk to them? They seem relaxed, but they are doing a group project together. So, is it a good time to talk to them? I think looking at the relaxed expression on their face and the smile, we can say now is a good time to interrupt if we have something we need to say. Again, looking at this group of people, is now a good time to interrupt? I see that there are several individuals looking at one thing. They're working together. They have a serious expression on their face. Okay? Serious expressions on their faces. They look a little bit busy. But if you must interrupt, now would be an okay time. This person seems to be very happy. It looks like she's received some good news. Is it a good time to interrupt? It's probably an okay time to interrupt. She's not too busy. She's not in a bad mood. Now might be okay.